Great. So what's the efficiency of this algorithm? Well, we had to go through pretty much the whole array a lot of times. Here's roughly what we did. Overall, we had to do 4 or n minus 1 iterations. And at each step, we did n minus 1 comparisons. So n minus 1 comparisons for n minus 1 iterations gives us something like this. We can use a little algebra to figure out what this simplifies to. And we get something that looks like this. Again, don't worry too much if you can't do the algebra. The minus 1 isn't changing much for us, so you could always just do n times n equals n squared. Thus, we really don't need this minus 2n plus 1 bit. We can get rid of it, and that leaves us with this is the efficiency, big O of n squared. Actually, there's a way we could have saved ourselves some time with this algorithm. If you noticed, each time we went through the array, we compared the last few values, even though we really didn't need to after a while. It made sense to compare 7 and 8 when we were bubbling up 7, but when we were bubbling up some of the lower numbers, this comparison didn't really change anything. The most common version of bubble sort actually leaves out this step every time of comparing the last few when you really don't need to do that. It assumes that after the first iteration, you know that 8 is in the right place, so you don't need to check it against anything else later. Again, this will save us some time, but it's not going to change our overall runtime of big O of n squared. I have a couple quick notes for you. Okay, so we understand why the worst case and the average case are going to be big O of n squared. However, the best case is actually going to be big O of n. The best case would either be that the array was already sorted, in which we can just go through it once, see that it's sorted, and not have to do anything else. Or if there's only one number that needs to be bubbled up to a new place in the array. And one last thing. We didn't have to use anything extra to do our sort. We had no extra arrays, no extra data structures, nothing like that. Bubble sort is a great example of an in-place sorting algorithm. So the space complexity is constant, meaning we didn't need any extra arrays or data structures in the whole process.